Hey kids, this is Rachel. I hope wherever you are in the world that you are doing well. As you can see, I have a blanket on currently. Where I'm at right now, it's starting to get cold outside, so we're getting a little bit more of winter weather. But if you're in a place that is nice and sunny, or you're nearby the beach, especially for those of you that are still in Grenada, I hope you are enjoying the warm weather. But I'm so excited to be able to bring today's lesson for you guys. But before we begin, I have an icebreaker question for you. And my question is, what is your favorite flavor of ice cream? Now, I'm one of those people that I love ice cream no matter the season. It could be freezing cold outside and snowing, or it can be blistering hot and sweating all over it, and I love ice cream either way. For me, my favorite flavor of ice cream is basically anything that has like caramel and brownie pieces in it. So something along the lines of maybe a chocolate chip cookie dough, or like a caramel brownie ice cream, or anything kind of in that realm of ice cream flavors, I am absolutely down for. So let me know what your favorite flavor is. I'm really excited to see. So today I want to talk about a man named Josiah. So if you have your Bibles with you, like I do, we're going to go into the book of 2 Chronicles, specifically chapters 34 and 35. Now, Josiah was a king who ruled over the land of Israel. And when he was appointed king, he was only 8 years old. Now, some of you might be thinking, oh my gosh, that's so young. And you're right, he was very, very young when he became crowned king. Some of you might be either around the age of 8, maybe a little bit older, maybe a little bit younger. But our story today actually takes place when he was a little bit older, when he was about 16 or 17. Now, one of the things to keep in mind was that before Josiah became king, all of the kings before him had been very, very evil, very bad, to the point that the nation of Israel had begun following the ways of some of the other nations surrounding them. So they were worshiping a lot of false gods, they were building idols and temples to these false gods and not worshiping the one true God. So Josiah was one of these kings who was put in place after all this time so that he could help the nation of Israel turn back to the Lord and to be able to reestablish themselves as the nation that God had chosen. So one of the things that Josiah decided to do when he was about 16 or 17 was he wanted to restore and he wanted to rebuild the temple. So he wanted to make sure that there was a place where the presence of God could dwell, but also so that it would help the people of Israel to turn back from all the wickedness that they had done and to be able to get right back on the path that they needed to be on. So what's actually kind of interesting is as they were repairing the temple and restoring it to its former glory, one of the priests actually found the book of the law that had been passed down through Moses. So those instructions, those laws, and those decrees that the Lord had given to Moses were written down, and this priest happened to find them after all these years. So he brought the book of the law to Josiah and showed him, hey, here's our instruction manual, here are the truths and the decrees that we have forgotten but we need to learn because of what God has established in them. So what Josiah decided to do was to use the book of the law. He gathered the priests, the elders, Levites, and he went before the entire nation, and essentially he rededicated the nation back to the Lord by remembering that these are the truths of God's word. No matter what might happen, they stand true forever. They don't change, they don't bend, but they're relevant even to this day. So I hope that's one of the things that you can take away from this story, was that even though sometimes we may forget what is truth or what may be going on around us is a little bit uncertain, we can always look to the Bible. We can always look to God's word to have truth that is forever. It never changes. It is always the same. But it's also a place where we can find comfort and we can find peace. And that's something that Josiah realized. He realized that the Bible is truth and that it's something that we should turn to and that the people of Israel should turn to as well. So I want to end this lesson today by going through the memory verse. The memory verse is actually found in Psalms 119, verse 142, and it says, "Your righteousness is everlasting and your law is true." I hope that's a verse that sticks with you and continues to remind you of not only who God is, but also how His word is true and it's good, and it's something that we should get ourselves involved in as much as we can, because it will guide our lives even when we're certain, but especially when we are uncertain about the things around us. So CSA, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next lesson.